Morning, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to a new day. It is Tuesday morning, almost noontime. It's 11:44. And right now, we have been blessed with another grocery haul from Walmart, from Tracy. So I'm going to have that haul for you in this video. But right now, for a late breakfast, we're having cinnamon swirl bagels, which Tracy sent over, with this brown sugar and cinnamon cream cheese spread. So she sent those, I believe it was last time, and we liked that, so she sent them again. And I have my winter snowman cup out. I've got some water boiling for some cappuccino. I already took Glenn some bagels and coffee, and so that's what we're gonna have for a late breakfast. And then so I'll have that grocery haul for you today, and what a blessing it is. So, I'll talk more about that when I do the grocery haul, but right now I'm going to have this for late breakfast. And then, so it is a very fall day today. That's why I have this cup out, and it is the season. So I actually still have to get a cup with fall stuff on it for drinking hot drinks like this. But it is windy today. It's supposed to be up to 17 or 18 mile per hour winds. The temperature dropped from 73 yesterday to 60. It was about a 10 or 11 degree drop from yesterday to what today is going to be. So, and you can tell in the air, we had a little bit of a dew point yesterday. It was like 62, so it was a little, not completely warm, but you could tell it was there. And today, the dew point is only 39. And when I took Gypsy out this morning, you could tell the difference in the air. Today is a crisp, colder air. Just the way I like it for fall time. Beautiful day for me. And it doesn't mean I want to be outside in the cold or anything. It just means I know it's cold outside, and I know I'm going to drink a hot drink and just have that cozy fall time feel. And I'm going to finish some fall stuff up today. So hopefully I get you that tour in this video. And today is just going to be a day in the house because it is so windy and it's too cold for Glenn to go outside. And tomorrow it's supposed to be back up to the 70s, so it'll be nicer for him to be outside. And we got to get a few odds and ends done before we go on our camping trip, which we are so excited about. So, all right, so but for now, let's eat. Yeah, I absolutely love these kind of days, these fall days. Warms my heart. Glenn doesn't like them so much, though. That means he's not going to go outside. Should have pushed that down already. All right, everyone. So here is my breakfast for this Tuesday morning. Some cinnamon swirl bagels with brown sugar and cinnamon cream cheese spread and some cappuccino. So I'm going to sit down and enjoy this, and we'll be back with the grocery haul. All right, everyone. So we're going to get into this friend mail via Walmart grocery haul. And this, again, comes from Tracy. Tracy, I don't even know what to say. We are so touched by this. All the groceries Tracy has sent us. I'm at a loss for words, honestly. And as I was bringing the groceries inside into the house, I was just really choked up and teary-eyed, kind of like I am right now, because I'm just like speechless. I don't even know what to say, except thank you, Tracy, from the bottom of our hearts. Glenn and I both appreciate this. Yeah, I don't. I'm just like really choked up and teary-eyed right now, and I can't believe it. All right, I'm gonna collect myself and I'll be right back. Okay, I think I'm ready. I think I'm ready. So, again, thank you, Tracy, so much. All right, so before I get into the haul, I'll just show you a little bit of my Halloween decorations. Now, I do decorate for Halloween, but not like the gory stuff. I'm not into the gory stuff. I like cutesy Halloween stuff, and I do put that stuff up. So, and I'm not finished. I still have fall to incorporate with that, so I'm just going to show you a couple of my decorations up here. Alright, so that's a vampire and mummy salt and pepper shaker. I got that at the Dollar Tree years ago. I thought they were so cute. And then just a spooky little mummy from the Dollar Tree. I've had these for years. And then that thing there, got at a garage sale years ago for a quarter. And it came in a set of three or four, I think. Three. And each one was like a quarter. So, oops, sorry. So, yeah. It's ceramic. But I think they're so cute. And then got this. I think that's cute. And I just put some fall leaves in there. And I think we got this with two other ones at a craft sale years ago. Or at a garage sale. I don't even remember. We've had these decorations for years. So, that's all I have on the kitchen shelf right now. I did decorate the holiday table and hung up some stuff, but I'm not done, so I don't want to show you till I'm done. And the holiday table has some like orange fairy lights, and it looks real pretty at night, so I don't want to record that till nighttime. All right, so so just to show you, and then I've got my tablet. I've got the one of my ambience videos on there, fall van life, and I put that on there just because we're going camping next week. So I don't have the sound on, but if you haven't visited my ambience channel, I'll leave the link in the description below to my other channel, Seasonal Ambience. If you haven't checked it out, go over there, check it out, subscribe, like, watch. Those videos are meant to just turn on and go about your day. So that helps me collect the watch hours so I can get monetized on that channel. So, but if you were to watch this, that has a sound of crackling fire on it. So yeah. Check that channel out if you haven't already. But for those of you who have gone over there to watch my videos, subscribe, like, share, comment, thank you so much. I appreciate the support. All right, so let's get into this haul now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to record this grocery haul, and then I'm going to upload it right away so you'll have it right away. And then whatever else I do today, I'll record for another video. And if you've been with the channel for a while, you know when I have grocery hauls, I like to categorize. So this is just your basic pantry items. And then I have a produce section, meat section, and snack section. So a lot more to come. Now let me ask you guys. All this stuff right here, applesauce, fruit cups, Jell-O cups, stuff like that. Do you categorize that as a snack or in your normal pantry items? Because we don't actually eat those as a snack. We eat them with a meal. So it's like a side dish to a meal. So drop it down in the comments. You consider that a snack or mostly towards your pantry items, I guess. All right, so now that you've seen that, so Tracy sent us all kinds of stuff here. This is a gel, pineapple in lime flavored gel. So it's like a Jell-O. You can tell it's gel in there, and it's got pineapples, and that gel's supposed to be. Okay, so my camera shut off because my SD card is out of storage. I have to go through and clear out a bunch of videos out of there, so I had to start it over and put the storage back to the phone. But yeah, I've never seen these before, so I think I might try one tonight with supper or even lunch. So got that. And then another gel pack with diced peaches in strawberry flavored gel. Interesting. So yeah, maybe try one flavor for lunch, one for supper. So got those. And there's a third gel pack. This is mandarin oranges in orange flavored gel. Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen those. Thank you so much. And then here is a pack, not gelled, of mandarin oranges in 100% juice. So we got those. And then if you've been with the channel for a while and you know us by now, you know we like the mango peach applesauce and the strawberry. So those are our two favorites. And Tracy sent two of each. So thank you so much. That gives us a good stock up on applesauce. We love to have applesauce as a side dish. We have it with some of our meals. So thank you, Tracy. So yeah, a lot of this, some stuff new to us and some of our old favorites. So there's that. All right, so we got a pack of Kinder's stew seasoning for a Sunday pot roast with rich gravy. And that, I believe, was sent over for a reason, but thank you, because when we get to that other part, I'll tell you a little something that I was planning on doing. So thank you for that. Stew seasoning from Kinder's. I don't think we've ever tried Kinder's anything seasonings, but I've heard they're really good. So good. Pretty excited to try that. And then a pack of chili seasoning mix. Now, as I let you know, I'm making chili for our camping trip, and I'm making both kinds. The juicy one for Glenn, the one with the spaghetti in it, and then the traditional style for myself. So I actually needed some chili seasoning, so thank you for that, Tracy. All right, so for breakfast, she sent this brown sugar, as you saw when we were eating it this morning, brown sugar and cinnamon cream cheese spread, and this pack of bagels, cinnamon swirl bagels. So we actually had one bagel each this morning, but what I'm going to do now is freeze these. There's four left, and save them for our camping trip. So we'll have some bagels while we're there in the morning. Because sometimes we really don't want a big breakfast, like cook eggs or bacon or something. Just some bagels in the morning, because if it's nice enough, we'll get up and we'll get ready to go fishing. So our main reason for going to this specific campground is for the fishing accessibility for Glenn. And the fishing is good, and the perch run should be in, so we're pretty excited. It's been 2 years, and we're just excited to go. So, all right, so saving the rest of these, I'm going to put them in the freezer for our camping trip. We got some of these hamburger rolls from Walmart's bakery. And the very first Walmart haul she sent us, she sent some of these with those hamburgers. And they are super soft. I like these hamburger buns. Yeah, they are super soft. So we got some of those. I'm going to move the camera back. It looks like it might be a little too close. And then she also sent the sweet Hawaiian slider buns. So there's 12 in there. I don't know if... Yeah, they're just like that, but they're sweet Hawaiian. I'm going to put them back now. I love Hawaiian rolls. So this is going to come in handy. All right, so we got those. And a can of petite diced tomatoes. And 2 cans of tomato soup. Because you know we like our tomato soup. All right, and French fries. I've never seen these before because I don't usually buy frozen French fries. But these are craft beer battered potatoes thin cut. So these are like a beer batter almost. So I'm pretty excited to try these. And I actually am going to try these tonight with something else she sent. So we'll get to that. And then she sent some barbecue sauce. And that would go with something else she sent. So you have to watch the whole video to see. And she knew that I used Heinz chili sauce for Glenn's chili. And she sent 2 of them because she knows I used 2 of them. So thank you so much. I actually had a little bit of a grocery list written out to get some of this stuff. And now I don't have to get it. So can't tell you how much I appreciate this. We appreciate this. A block of cream cheese, and you'll know what that's for in just a little bit here. All right, so this is what I would consider the pantry staples. So I'm going to put this stuff away, and I'll be back with the next section. All right, so we have our produce section here, and we have a 3-pound bag of Fuji apples. Thank you so much. And we have a bag of baby carrots. And a bag of these Halos. We absolutely love these Halos. I think this is the 3rd time we've been sent these. And I remember the first time we tried those, because I don't think we ever tried Halos. We were always getting those little cuties. And there is a difference between the two. I think the little cuties are more bitter, and these were like a sweetness with a little bitterness, so it kind of cancels each other out. But yeah, the first time she sent these, we actually loved them. We went through the bag so fast, so thank you. And these are going to actually be good snacks for our camping trip. We'll eat some before that, but we'll definitely take some camping if they survive the weekend. The rest of the week and the weekend. All right, and then a 10-pound bag of potatoes. How amazing is that? So thank you so much for this produce. All right, so I'm going to put this away and bring on the next section. I think there's 2 more sections. All right, everyone, so here is the snack section. And yes, Tracy sent a lot of stuff for our camping trip. And she did let me know ahead of time she was sending something. And yeah, I don't think we actually have to buy anything for this camping trip. Yeah, I think we're set. So thank you so much, Tracy, for taking that off our plates. And there is a meat section to come after this, so you'll see the complete circle it makes. So, all right, so let's go over the snacks. So first right here, she sent us stuff for making s'mores. So we've got some graham crackers. We've got a 6-pack of full-size Hershey bars. and a bag of big marshmallows. So I can't wait to make some s'mores. I've only had s'mores one time in my life, and that was about 3 or 4 years ago. So yes, can't wait to do that. All right. Okay, so let's move this out of the way and go to the other snacks. So Tracy sent a box of these Welch's Island fruit snacks, and there's 22 pouches in them. And I took a pouch out so you could see how big the pouches are. They're kind of like it fits in my hand, and they're kind of like the size of packs you give away at Halloween or something like that. So, and Glenn actually loves these, and these snacks, all of it, is going to be perfect for when we're fishing on our camping trip, because a lot of times when we go fishing and our campsite is actually just right next to the water, so when we're fishing and if we get hungry, I normally just walk over to our campsite and make some sandwiches or stuff and get some snacks and bring them over to our fishing place. So you'll see, I'm going to take video and you're going to see how convenient this is for Glenn to go fishing. This is why this is the only campground we ever go to, because we know it. It's convenient for Glenn and the fishing is good there. So I can't wait to take you along. Many of you have seen our past camping trips. So I can't wait to take some of the newer folks, and some of you that have already seen it would like to see it again. So I can't wait for this. All right, so we got the fruit snacks, and that's what I mean when these are perfect for our camping trip when we're fishing. I'm going to take my backpack, and I can just throw this stuff in the backpack, and we'll be set for our snacks. All right, so I opened it already. So you can see they fell out of the bottom. I opened the wrong end. And I already gave Glenn a little baggie of these nuts as well as the pistachios. But I took a pack out so I can show you. And I opened the wrong end, and I told myself, remember to hold it when you pick it up. And I did not. So and it went all flying out. But these are Planters Nutrition Wholesome Nut Mix. So there's cashews, almonds, macadamia with a touch of sea salt. And they come in these little pouches again. Fit in my hand. And there's 7 packs in there. So perfect. Thank you so much. And then the next one are these pistachios. Wonderful pistachios. No shells. So these are already shelled. They come in a variety of pack. There's 9 packs in here, and they're these little snack size packs, as big as my hand, and there's 9 of these. And the 3 flavors that are in there are honey roasted. There's 2 packs of that, 4 packs of this, which is the regular roasted and salted, and 3 packs of the chili roasted. So I've already taken Glenn a pack of the chili roasted. I promise you we're going to save the rest of these for the camping trip. But this is the chili roasted, and he tried them and he said there is a bit of spice to them. So he said, I don't think you're going to like them, babe. I already knew that. I was already counting on the honey roasted and the roasted and salted. So thank you so much for that. We love pistachios, but we never buy them. They're kind of pricey, so we just don't buy them. But so we got that. And she sent over a bag of Lifesavers, and they're individually wrapped. This is 14 and a half ounces, and these look like the traditional flavors. And Glenn loves to just have these little candies around, so I eat them too. But thank you so much for that. And for the bag of Fuji apples, she sent over some caramel dip. So nothing went without its partner. So those apples go with the partner is the caramel dip. So thank you so much. And then for chips, she sent over Lay's sour cream and onion, which we eat, and a bag of these Sun Chips, Harvest Cheddar. So Glenn actually has never had Sun Chips. I have. So yeah, we'll see how he likes them. I know I'll eat them. So there's Sun Chips and a tube of plain Pringles. I love Pringles. I do like Pringles. So thank you so much. And the last thing in the snacks is I mentioned I was going to make a no-bake cheesecake for the camping trip. And she sent a box of mix for the no-bake cheesecake. So this is a no-bake original cheesecake dessert mix. So all you need to do is add sugar, milk, and butter. Yeah, so you just need to add those. I actually thought that block of cream cheese I was going to have to add to this, but I'm not going to. So thank you so much. And then she sent over a can of strawberry pie filling to put over the cheesecake. So that is going to be delicious. So that is the snacks she sent over, that Tracy sent over for our camping trip. And obviously, we ate a couple already. Well, Glenn ate a couple already. But thank you so much, Tracy, for all these snacks. I think this haul has a really good balance between staple items, produce, snacks, and meat, as you'll see when I bring up the meat. So I'm going to put this away and stay tuned for the meat section. All right, everyone. So here is the last section, and it is the meat section. So holy moly, look at everything she sent. So blessed. So grateful, thankful, everything. All right, so let's go over what she sent us. Two pack of this ham steak. And the last time she sent these, I used one for that macaroni salad. And then the other one we used for like ham omelets or something like that. So thank you so much. We can always use ham steak in different meals. And then we got a pack of hot dog buns, or hot dog buns, hot dogs. And these are the bun-sized beef. We like to get the bun-length ones, so that's good. And we are going to take these on our camping trip. So, and that's as easy as throwing it on the fire. And I don't know if you like that or if you've ever done that for hot dogs. Throw it on the fire and blacken it up. Those always taste actually the best. All right, so, and look at this. A 12-pack of Johnsonville Better Cheddar sausages. How amazing is that? So, yeah. We're definitely going to take some of these to our camping trip. I am going to use a couple of them tonight for Glenn's supper, and I'll tell you about that in just a minute. But we are definitely going to save most of these for the camping trip. So thank you so much. And look at this. This pack of boneless pork ribs. They're cut up. They're actually ribs. They just don't have a bone. Perfect. I love boneless. So, yes. And that barbecue sauce you saw in the pantry staple section, I'm guessing is for this. So, I may make this. You know, this is amazing because we're just like running low on stuff. We just have, with all the up and go, you know, going we've been doing, we just haven't gone to the grocery store, and we're just trying to spread out our money a little bit. So we've been eating just a lot of this and that, you know, sandwiches, you know, hot dogs, things like that, and just trying to stretch things a little bit, I guess. So this actually all comes at a perfect time because last night I made the flounder in one of the last grocery hauls she sent us from Walmart. She sent a bag of flounder fillets, And I made some of those last night. I didn't record it. I haven't recorded much, like I said. I've just been enjoying time and just... There'll be plenty of time for recording when we go on our camping trip and when we come back. And once we're in the house for the winter, the rest of the fall and winter, there's going to be a ton of recording going on. So right now I'm just kind of enjoying things and not doing as much recording just so I don't get burnt out. Okay, so yeah, last night I made flounder fillets. And I made it the regular way I always make them. Just coat them in egg wash and flour and then fry them up. And I made some white rice with them. Alright, so we're actually probably going to use a lot of this week. Because that's how low we were getting on our meats. But these boneless ribs, I think I might make these tomorrow. Maybe with some baked potato and a canned corn or vegetable or something. So, yeah, I think I'll do that. So that's Wednesday. Today's Tuesday, Wednesday. Tuesday's taken care of Wednesday, and then we'll get to the rest of that. And then look at this, a 3-pound tube of ground beef chuck. So this is 80-20, so that actually is a good, I like to get the 80-20 because I think it's a perfect split between the fat and the lean. It's not too fatty, so you don't get a bunch of fat juice and lose a lot of your meat, but it's not too lean, so you still get some fat juice and still have a lot of your meat in there. So I think 80-20 is perfect. So a 3-pound tube of ground beef chuck. So thank you so much. Oh, and look at this, a chuck roast. How amazing is that? This is a 2.44-pound chuck roast. Perfect. So let me tell you, I said I was going to tell you a little something. I will actually, like I said, I had a grocery list planned to go get stuff today. Because, one, we were low on stuff, and two, because we needed a couple of things for the camping trip. And I actually had on my list to get a chuck roast at Pick and Save because they were on sale. So I was going to get one so I could make a pot roast this week. And look what she sent. A chuck roast, potatoes, carrots, the seasoning, the whole thing sent to us. Oh, can't believe it. Cannot believe it. So a chuck roast will go in our slow cooker. Or I think actually we like to cook it in the roasting pot and put it in the oven. So I think I'm going to do that. So I'll have carrots, potatoes, that seasoning, the roast. Perfect. Thank you so much for supplying all this to us. Oh, heaven sent. And then a box of these hamburgers. There's this is a 2-pound box. And I think, six burgers. And they're thick. I like these. Glenn's not a big fan of them. But I actually don't mind them at all. I like to eat these. So for tonight's supper, we're already going to dig into this meat. For tonight's supper, I'm actually, with those buns she sent over, I'm going to make myself a couple hamburgers, and I'm going to fry up some bacon with it. So I'll make a bacon cheeseburger. I just don't have tomato. We've got Miracle Whip, cheese, lettuce, I think. But I'll probably just do the Miracle Whip, ketchup, cheese, and bacon. So I'll make myself a couple bacon cheeseburgers. I won't eat both of them right away. I usually like to make one and have it for later on if I get hungry at night. Yeah, we are late night snackers. So, enough. So if you've been listening to that cat whine in the background, that is Blackie. They've gotten to the point, they think if they whine enough, even though they didn't finish the last food I put out, that if they whine enough, I'll put out more. And I'm refusing to do that, so he's going to keep whining. And no, it's like I'll put food down, they'll decide they don't want that one, and leave it there and wait for me to put out more, but I refuse to. So if they're hungry, they'll eat it. So that's why he's whining. Patches, that's more Blackie and Prissy. Patches is very good. He'll eat dry food and wet food. If he doesn't like wet food as much as dry food, but he will eat some of it. And if it's something he don't like, he don't eat it. But if he gets hungry later, he comes back to munch on it and eat a little bit of dry food at the same time. So, totally happy with Patches' eating habits. All right, so yeah, couple burgers for me tonight. And then that's where I said I'm going to use a couple of these better cheddars tonight. For Glenn, I'm going to make him a couple of the better cheddars. And I'm going to make him a foil pack with potatoes, carrots, and onions. And that'll be his supper. So we'll do that tonight, which is Tuesday. Wednesday, we'll do the boneless pork ribs. Maybe Thursday, we'll do the pot roast. And that'll be enough for two nights. So that's Thursday, Friday, and then we just got Saturday and Sunday. Well, Sunday I'll be making chili to take for the camping trip, but we'll eat it Sunday night as well. So we are, and that one's Prissy. we are so set right now. Thank you so much. All right, and then the last things, lunch meat. So she sent over a pack of hard salami, thin sliced, lunch meat. So they come in the pack, and that's so convenient because I keep these plastic containers. So we got some salami, and then Lando Frost premium meat, oven roasted chicken breast lunch meat. I actually love chicken breast and turkey breast lunch meat for sandwiches. Glenn is not a fan of either one of those for lunch meat. So, but he is a fan of honey ham. Glenn does like honey ham for lunch meat. So she did send over some honey ham. So these are 1 pound bags. So that's perfect. I'm sure we'll eat some of it while we're still here, but we'll save some of it for our camping trip for those times I go and grab some sandwiches while we're fishing. So that is our friend mail via Walmart grocery haul delivery. How amazing is that? Thank you so much, Tracy. I can't even say it enough. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts for this wonderful gift to us. And as you can see, I'm already planning to use it this week. All right, so yeah, so blessed. So amazingly blessed. But I'm going to go ahead and edit this video and get it uploaded right away so you have this video. And anything that I record going forward the rest of the day, I'll put on the next video. All right, so I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you again, Tracy, so very much. Many blessings to you. And thank you all for taking time out of your day to watch my videos. I appreciate all of you, and with that, remember to live life, be good to yourself, and be good to others. Until next time.